people, what's going on? This is B.Dillinger. How are you? Welcome to today's tutorial. In today's tutorial, we're actually going to be making a sunglass case. And so I'm going to be using these particular sunglasses as my kind of reference point. So again, you can grab whatever sunglasses you want, but I'm going to be using these. For this particular tutorial, you're just going to need some basic supplies. So you're going to need some tape, pair of scissors, pencil, marker or Sharpie, or you know, just whatever kind of thing you've got that's like this. Scratch awl, great to have. You're also going to need to know what type of closure you're going to be using for this. I'm going to actually be using this collar stud. I bought this from a place called Ohio Travel, and I'll have all the information if you want to use this type of thing in the description box down below. And you're also going to need a ruler and a regular piece of paper. Anyway, that's it. Let's get into this video. So let's get into it. The first thing you want to do is you want to take a piece of paper and then the long way, fold it in half. Take one end and just fold it up, like so. And then basically what that leaves you with is a piece of paper folded into quadrants. Okay? Then take your Sharpie marker and your ruler. You want to do is you just want to take a piece of tape and you want to lay your glasses, let me turn this around for you guys, so that your glasses are on either side of that center mark and you're using the bridge of the glasses as a guide to get you like dead center. Take your piece of tape and then just secure the glasses to the paper. I'm just going to secure it to the legs in the back so that they don't move around. Then take your piece of paper, fold that up and over. And then just be careful to line up, turn this around for you guys, just be careful to line up those two lines, okay? And then in terms of like how tight you should do this, don't do it very tight, but just kind of like tight enough to get over the top of it. And then what I would do is I would just hold it with your finger just to make sure that you've got it. So the next thing you want to do is you just want to feel the width of your glasses in there. And so if I can just kind of feel how they go, turn this around, if I can just kind of feel how they go, you know, I can feel like just by, you know, pressing the paper down, that they're about right there. So basically what that tells us is that, see if I can feel that, you know, that's our first line. And you know, just as we're working this pattern, just remember that we're going to continue to work on half of it. So again, this is kind of the extent of where our glasses go. Then you want to take your piece of paper and push it down a little bit more. Basically what you want to do is you kind of with your fingers want to shape where your sunglasses go. And basically what I mean to say is that where the top paper and the bottom paper meet, we need to have that flush. And then we need to kind of go by the line that we made. So what I would do is I would add maybe about, you know, a quarter of an inch to that for a little bit of breathing room for the glasses. And we're also going to be using that for the seam allowance, because the seam allowance that we're doing on this is probably going to be an eighth of an inch at the very most, not very much. So what we want to figure out is how far the glasses come over. And it looks like they come over to about right there, and that's going to be our kind of squared line. So that's kind of where we need to go to get started. So now let's unwrap this. So taking our piece of paper, what we do is we just take it and we fold it in half the long way. And what we want to deal with is just this top edge, okay? So what I would do is I would take my ruler here, and so remember where we made our top edge right there? We just want to square that line. And to that, just because we need a little bit of breathing room, I would add maybe like a quarter of an inch just to the top of it, because we definitely want to cover those glasses. Let's just clean this up a little bit. So let's bring this up about right there. Okay, and we just want to make sure that our line is flush, and then we want to make sure that we've got a really nice curve that's, you know, so if this is the edge of our glasses, we want to follow that a little bit more so that this shape is pretty and it's, you know, attractive looking. Okay, so now we've got that. Now you want to take your scissors and we want to cut that. So what I would do is along this bottom line, I would just cut over like that and then just come back around. Then you want to take your piece of paper and fold it back up, right? And then you just want to line up your center mark there, okay? And you might have to just do a little small adjusting or whatever. What we do is we want to trace off this edge, okay? Let's trace that off. Okay. Then go back to your piece of paper, right? Fold this in half. And then we just want to cut along that line. So that you kind of have this shape. All right, get rid of that. Open this up, take a piece of tape, and then fold this up. Then apply a piece of tape. Take your glasses, drop them in there, okay? Glasses in there. Now, this is your center front, so let's just mark that. I'm just gonna abbreviate and write CF, working with this. So this is now gonna become our flap. So just take that and fold it over and line it up with this line in the front. So you just want to take care that you don't do it too tight. You want to give it a little breathing room. So I would just give it a really nice fold and then line that up. Then you want to figure out how you want your flap to be. So I think I want my flap to do something like, I don't know, coming from right here and then just kind of coming up a little bit. All right, so that's kind of what I want. And I think the distance between here and here is pretty good using this collar button. So what I would do is I would figure out the placement of it, which is probably about right there. Go back to my scratch awl and just lightly pierce all the way through the paper. And then what that will do is that will tell us that's kind of where our fixture needs to sit on both sides. And I'm just gonna mark it a little bit so that we don't lose track of it. Then take your pattern upside down. Now the back side, you guys can see that. And then we need to figure out a couple of things. So we've got this transition that goes over the top and onto the side. So this is kind of where we need to look. Okay. We just need to match it up with the shape that we're doing on the front. I think you guys can kind of see this. Now this is a hot mess. Okay, it's not perfect, but we just want to get some sense of what we're trying to do, you know. And like I said, this is our, you know, basic pattern, working pattern. It's gonna be messy, don't worry about it. We're gonna clean it up in a second. But that's kind of what we're after. Then what I would do, take your glasses out, take your scissors, and let's cut this apart. This is now the top edge of what your pattern needs to do. Take your piece of paper, fold it in half, because we're always working on the half. And then I would use, what I would do is I would just clean this up a little bit. Go back to your ruler. Square your line. What I'm doing now, this really depends on whatever shape that you're gonna do. This is the shape that I want, but you will correct it as per whatever shape you want. So one other thing. So as we're correcting this, I would take this part, and fold it up, because this intersection, I think you guys can see that. Let me hold this up for you. This intersection is where the front flap and the side meet. So we want to make sure that we stay on top of that so that those are even, and then we blend it, blend our line on the side. So let me just get that worked out there. Nice little transition, keep it smooth, nothing too abrupt. And then when we hit that corner, you know, I kind of want a nice corner, right? Then I would take my scissors and let's just cut this apart. And then just one more time, take a piece of tape. Down. And then we just want to line up our spots. Okay. And there goes our sunglasses. All right. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to take this and transfer it to a piece of Oaktag paper. Okay, so for this part of the drafting of the pattern, you're gonna need a cutting tool. I always use an X-Acto knife. So an X-Acto knife, your Sharpie marker again, pencil, your scratch awl. If you're using Oaktag paper, you won't need this if you're just using regular paper. You'll need your ruler, and I'm also gonna be using something called a French curve. Again, not necessary if you're pretty good doing freehand, but I do think that this gives you a smoother line. So let's get started. Next, take your piece of Oaktag paper, and then also about Oaktag paper. If you don't happen to have any, don't worry, you can always use a manila folder because you don't need that much. So I just want to mention that to you. So let me just put all my tools and stuff to the side here so I can just do some work. Do some work for y'all. So next, let's take your pattern. Piece of paper, or whatever you want to call it, scratch all, mark down the center, put that away. Okay. Take your paper pattern that we've been working on, our hot mess pattern, lay that on there, and you want to lay it on there so that it is exactly on the edge. Turn that around so you guys can see, just like that. Okay, so do that. Line that up so that's all good in the hood. Take your pencil, and then what we're going to do is we're just going to trace around it. Okay, so now you've got your pattern traced. You don't need that anymore. Well, let's just Alright, so what I'm going to do is get my paper pattern here. I'm going to take my scratch awl and make a mark right where I want it to bend. Paper up. Go in here, insert into the spot, and then line it up with the other spot. This is where your the intersection of the side. Line that up. X-Acto knife, let's cut this out. Oh, and then just one other thing. Whenever I'm cutting out Oaktag paper, what I don't do is I don't try to cut through two layers at the same time. I do each layer individually. And if you're asking why do I do that, it's because, you know, when you're crossing over this fold line, you know, things have a tendency to shift. And so I definitely feel you can get more accuracy if you just cut them out one by one. So now you got that, and just fold that over. pencil. So now here's our pattern. Okay. It's pretty good. Go back to our original pattern, and remember those marks that we made for the closure? We just want to transfer those onto what we're calling our working pattern or our master pattern. So going back to your scratch all here, get that in position, get everything lined up, and then we just want to make a mark where we want those fixtures to go. Okay, and then we can discard that. Then going back to your pen here, let's put some markings on this. So let's mark out the direction that we need to lay the piece. Now if you're using leather, this won't necessarily apply because unless your leather has a direction or a grain, you can lay this on leather. However, if you are in fact using another material such as a fabric, you're going to have to do some more engineering because the pattern making that I'm showing you is specifically geared toward leather. So, if you're working with fabric, you can't really use a raw edge with fabric. You have to turn your edge, and that's again because I'm using leather. It's one of the reasons why I prefer leather over. Let's be honest. It's one of the reasons why I prefer leather over fabric because you don't have to do those finished edges, turn edges, marrowed edges. That type of thing. You can just cut it straight away, or your thing is going to be raw edge. So put that on there. Next, we just want to mark off what we're calling this. So we're going to call this do-it-yourself sunglasses case. Okay. And then for me, I'm going to be cutting one of the outside, which is a particular color. And then I'm also going to cut an additional one for the inside. So I'm actually going to be cutting two. Where you go from here is really up to you, depending on the kind of thing and style that you want. So let me just move on. So for mine, I decided to go with this kind of dark green, almost dark teal green, and then I'm going to pop it with this orange. So this will be my outside and this will be the inside. So basically I'm just going to take my pattern now, lay this down, trace it out, and cut it. So let me just do that. Okay, so I've cut out my pieces, and so I've got my dark green on the outside, my orange on the inside. I also, did a top stitch along the top of the front, and then flipping this over, I also did a top stitch around the flap. So going back to your pattern here, lay this down. You need your rotary tool. And then your collar stud is in two pieces. So this piece, there's a little screws to the back. Go right in there. Right over. Screw that on. So now, considering the size of this, I'm going to use the largest hole on my rotary punch. Do that. You're just going to make like a little small slit going right here. And basically what that does is that it relieves the pressure from your collar stud passing through. Nice and straight, a couple of slices in there, and if you guys can see that right there, it just makes a little slice. right? So that when this goes, passes through, it just pops and wraps right along there, okay? Let's undo that. So just grabbing a couple of binder clips. We're gonna put this together, okay? And so I'm just gonna go to the machine and sew this together and I'll be right back. So I've sewn up the sides, and now what I wanna do is just go in here and I just wanna clip my threads. Okay, grab your sunglasses, drop them in your sunglasses case. Is good to go. All right, that's it.